Greta has a computer that she uses for schoolwork and leisure. The computer has a media access control MAC address. Tick to show whether the MAC address is initially assigned to the computer by the network, the manufacturer, or the user. So a quick recap on MAC addresses. MAC addresses are assigned to network interface controllers. So generally when devices such as computers, tablets, phones, smartwatches even are manufactured, they are able to connect to the internet. A MAC address is used to identify a device on a network, and so it's vital for any device that wants to connect to the internet. And generally, it's going to be assigned by the manufacturer. So we can take manufacturer as the correct answer. Next question, the values in the MAC address are hexadecimal values. Convert the three given hexadecimal values into 8-bit binary. We have 1, 4, A0, and C9. To convert a hexadecimal number into a binary number, we're going to convert each individual hexadecimal number by itself. Bear in mind that the first 10 digits of hexadecimal are just denary. So if we're converting a value like 1 into binary, it's going to be the same method as converting the denary number 1 into binary. Let's have a look at this. So starting off with the number 1, the main thing to keep in mind is that each hexadecimal value can be stored using 4 binary bits. So to store 4 binary bits, or to write out 4 binary bits, we're going to use the same method that we've done before, which is to start with 1 on the right hand side, multiply this number by 2, multiply 2 by 2, multiply 4 by 2, until we get 4 numbers. These represent our 4 binary bits. Now all we do is we work out which numbers we need to make up this number over here. To make up 1, you can see we only need 1. So we're going to cancel the numbers that we don't need and circle the number that we do need. Wherever we've cancelled, we're going to write a 0. And wherever we've circled, we're going to write a 1. And that is our first 4 bits. We then have the number 4. So let's work out 4. Again, we'll employ the same method. 1, 2, 4, 8. We'll work out which numbers we need to make up 4. In this case, it's only 4. So cancel the 8, circle the 4, cancel the 2, cancel the 1, and we can write down 0, 1, 0, 0. So our first number is going to be the combination of these two, one after the other. Make sure that you get the right order. In this case, we have 1 and 4. So we want to write down the answer as 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. Also just verify that it is indeed 8 bits, and you can do that by counting the bits. You shouldn't have more than 8 bits, but if you do, let's say you have an extra 2 zeros, you can just make it so that it's 8 bits by removing the initial zeros. Next number we have A0, let's go ahead and do this. First number we have A. A is not a denary number, meaning we need to convert it into denary first. If we remember what the conversions are for hexadecimal and denary, we can write them down here. As we said earlier, the first 10 digits of hexadecimal are just denary. Thereafter, we have A, B, C, D, E, and F. And these correspond to the values 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15 in denary. So A is going to be equivalent to 10. Let's now do the same method. So we're going to write down 1, 2, 4, and 8. Let's work out which of these numbers we need to add together to add up to 10. You should be able to work out that it's going to be 8 and 2. And that's just a bit of mental math to work that out. So circle the 8, cancel the 4, circle the 2, cancel the 1. Whichever numbers we've circled, we'll write down a 1. Whichever numbers we've cancelled, we'll write down a 0. All right, so that is our first number. The second number is 0. And a quick tip, 0 is going to be the same across all number systems. In this case, we just have 4 zeros. All right, very important to put these 4 zeros. So we can't simply just write a single 0. Otherwise, this binary number would be incomplete. So we need to make sure that we have 4 zeros. All right, our number then becomes 10100000. Let's write that down in the answer. Very important to make sure that we have all 4 zeros over there, because one single hexadecimal digit is equivalent to 4 binary bits. Next one we have is C9. Let's go ahead and do that. First number is C. That is equivalent in denary to 12. So again, writing down 1, 2, 4, and 8. Which numbers do we need to make up 12? That's going to be 8 and 4. We can circle these two, and we can cancel out the 2 and the 1. So we're going to write down 1, 1, 0, 0, just as before. The next number we have is 9. So 9 is already in denary, meaning we don't have to do any conversions. And we can write down 1, 2, 4, and 8. The numbers to make up 9 is 8 and 1. Let's circle those, cancel out the rest, and we're left with 1, 0, 0, 1. So the answer then is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. A very nice conversion is the hexadecimal into 8-bit binary, because it's very quick, it's very simple, as long as you make sure that every single hexadecimal digit is made up of 4 binary bits, and only 4 binary bits, then you'll be good. Moving on with the next question, convert the two given hexadecimal values into denary. So the method that we're going to use is to first convert our hexadecimal value into its binary form, and then we're going to convert it into denary. And I'll show you why we do this. Let's just erase everything else first. Looking at the number C8, to convert this directly into denary, it is possible to do. However, the method uses quite a bit more math than is necessary. The method that we use is to take each individual hexadecimal number, and we're going to write down now the powers of 16 underneath it. So we're going to write down first off 16 to the power of 0 and 16 to the power of 1. Now all we do is we multiply each number in the column. So we're going to multiply C by 16, and we're going to multiply 8 by 16. You may be asking, how do you multiply C by 16? We just do our denary conversion. So this will be equivalent to 12 multiplied by 16, then going to add it to 8 multiplied by 16 to the power of 0 is just 1. Anything to the power of 0 is always 1. So we can write down just 1. And that's going to be our calculation. You can see that multiplying 12 by 16 is not the easiest to do. And unfortunately, you aren't allowed to take your calculator into the exam, so you won't be able to do this multiplication very quickly. If you're pretty good at mental math, then you can definitely use this method, but I prefer the method of converting it first into binary and then converting it into denary. It's just a bit of a safer method than doing this. So we'll do that for the first number 29. To convert hex into binary, we've done this already in this question over here, so we can do this pretty quickly now. For the first number, we have 2. That's going to give us the numbers 1, 2, 4, and 8 for the binary bits. That gives us the binary number 0010. The next number is 9. 9, if we write down our 4 binary bits, 1, 2, 4, and 8, the numbers are 8 and 1. So our binary number is 1001. We now have the binary number 0010. 1001, and we can now convert this into denary. So converting this into denary, we've done this conversion before. Let's make a bit more space first. The method to convert a binary number into denary is by starting on the far right-hand side, which is our least significant bits, and writing a 1 above it. Then we're going to continuously multiply this number by 2 until we get to the end. So 1 multiplied by 2, multiplied 2 by 2 is 4, multiply 4 by 2 is 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. Now all we do is cancel the numbers that have a 0, and we're going to circle the numbers that have a 1. So 128, that has a 0 bit, so we cancel it out. 64 has a 0 bit, we cancel that out. 32 has a 1 bit, so we can circle that. 16, that's on a 0 bit, cancel it out. 8, we can circle. 4 gets cancelled, 2 is going to get cancelled, and 1 we're going to keep. We can then add these numbers together, so we're left with 32 plus 8 plus 1, and working this out, we get the number 41. So that is our first denary number, which is our first answer. Let's do C8, writing down C8 over here. Again, working out each of these hexadecimal numbers individually, C is going to be equivalent to 12. So which numbers do we need to make up 12, given the 8, 4, 2, 1? Well, we've worked it out before, that was 8 and 4. So our number is going to be 1100, as we've done. 8 is already a denary number, and the numbers that we need is just 8. So our number is 1000. We're left with the binary number 1100, 1000. Let's write the numbers above, and we'll circle the numbers that have a 1 bit and cancel the numbers that have a 0 bit. Adding up these numbers, we get 128 plus 64 plus 8, which gives us 200 as our number. Let's write in 200, and there is our question finished. So with this entire section of converting between hexadecimal, binary, and denary, you only really need to remember 4 different methods. The hexadecimal to binary, binary to hexadecimal, binary to denary, and denary to binary. Hexadecimal to binary, these methods are very similar, and the methods from binary to denary are also very similar. So you realistically only need to practice 2 different methods. Once you've got those methods down, you can do any conversion without actually having to know the hexadecimal to denary conversion, or vice versa. And that's how I'd recommend studying this section.